horn. Barack Obama is of the belief the last thing you want to do is raise taxes in a recession. That was he said that in 2009. And so let's see what Paul Ryan has to say.
Yeah, he was on the Morning Joe show, Paul Ryan.
Republicans and Democrats have been doing this. And we've got to stop picking winners and losers in the tax code, clear out the loopholes, lower the tax rates, and give businesses certainty and make us more competitive internationally so we can compete.
Yeah, and the real key to all of this stuff, everything, it would be this. Take the money away from the progressives. Get the money away from them. And you do that by shrinking government, cutting government, get rid of these union jobs, and getting rid of these this burden. You know, 32% of the workforce is union.
32%.
If it gets to 18%, you can all kiss it goodbye. And that's what they're going to do. That's what regulations do. That's what these regulations are all about, is expanding that job market from 32 to 50%. Give me 23.
What we don't like is repeating mistakes. Look, Bush tried temporary tax rebates. Obama tried temporary tax rebates, and they have proven not to create jobs. All this temporary booster shot stimulus didn't work in the stimulus package. It didn't work when the last administration tried these things. So we don't want to go with ideas that have proven to fail. We want to go with ideas that have proven to succeed. So,
exactly.
That was on the Morning Joe show. Now, Senator Marco Rubio has made some statements then, too, huh?
Yeah, he's jumped in here a little bit on the economy, the jobs, and unemployment. What do you have here? Give me 24 here, Tommy.
He's part of a group of people that actually think the free enterprise system, to some extent, is unfair. It leads to too much inequality, that we should be moving towards economic justice instead of economic opportunity. And I think he misunderstands the role of government and what government can do. I think he sincerely believes that presidents and senators can create jobs, and there are things we can do to create an environment for job creation. But ultimately, jobs are created by everyday people from all walks of life that start a business or grow an existing business. Our job is to make it easier for them to do that. I think if the president understood that, we'd be better off economically.
Well, key factor, first of all,
he does understand that. Everything he's doing, Mr. Rubio, is purposeful. This isn't somebody who says, let me take a shot at it. I think my policies might work. He knows they won't work. Number 25, please.
I think if we do a few things, we could have one of the largest economic expansions in American history. There's a lot of people standing on the sidelines, ready to invest in America's future, but they're not going to do it unless our tax code works, unless our regulations are under control, and unless we have a plan to deal with our national debt. If we do that, I think tomorrow's going to be better than today.
Get rid of the tax code as it exists and redo it. Get rid of the IRS.
Really, the only job I think it's designed to protect is his. There are some things there, the payroll tax holiday, that's fine. But the plan is not a serious effort to create jobs in America. I think it's largely a political move. What the president is saying he wants to do to help create jobs in America, they're not going to work. It's basically a lot of the stuff we've tried before. All it does is cost us money. It doesn't end up creating economic opportunity. What it takes to grow the economy is tax reform, regulatory reform, some certainty about our debt. These are the things that have worked in the past. And these are things that will work in the future. That's what we as policymakers should be focused on here in Washington.
Get the government out of people's lives, you'll be all right. This jobs bill is not designed to save Obama's job. That is an opinion put on him and his behavior by Republicans who don't understand his business model. His business model is purposeful. He knows it won't create jobs. He doesn't care. He wants it to collapse. And when it collapses, it gives him the perfect opportunity to say, see, the American way of life is finished. It doesn't work. George Bush destroyed the economy. I inherited it. And now the government has to get in there and tax you and now redistribute wealth. That's
a classic. Email Fred Dreyer, F. Dreyer, D-R-Y-E-R, at CRNI.net. FDreyer@CRNI.net.
Yeah, we're going to come back next week, and we're going to really get on this stuff. We want to thank you for joining in. I am Fred Dreyer along with Michael Horn, and great speaking with you, and we will see you next week.